Hi everyone, my name is Sienna. In this video, we will learn how to add XR simulation to your arfoundation project. You need to use arfoundation 5 and above. With XR simulation, we will be able to test our AR project directly in Unity Editor without needing to build to a device or physically move to a different location. When this video is released, this is all the features supported. But there is still some limitation. XR simulation cannot exactly replicate device behavior and shouldn't be considered a replacement for on-device testing. So you still need to fully test your app on your targeted device. XR simulation is to quickly test on some features without requiring a new build. Some AR features also have limitations in XR simulation. For a plane detection, planes are only detectable on axis-aligned surface. And for meshing, meshes are all detected immediately on entering play mode. That's all for the explanation. Make sure you already have all the setup, such as the packets, and XR origin and also AR session in your scene. If you don't have the project set up, you can watch my basic setup video to know how to set up your project. You need to use Unity New Input System for the interaction. Make sure the active input handling in player setting is set to both. You can use pointer for the input. Pointer is a mouse input on PC and a touch input on mobile. So you can use the same script for the editor and your targeted device. Now let's start adding XR simulation to your project. Go to Edit, Project Settings, then in XR Plugin Management, go to Windows, and then enable XR simulation. Now when you open an AR scene and press the play button, you can test your project in the editor. You can navigate around in the same way as in the scene view. Hold down the right mouse button. Move the mouse to look around. Use the WASD keys to move left, right, forward, and backward. And use the Q and E keys to move up and down. You can hold down Shift to move faster. And it also has a lot of settings that you can edit to change how XR simulation works according to your project's needs. To do it, go back to Project Settings, then under XR Plugin Management, open XR Simulation. You can see the explanation for its setting in Unity documentation. You can also change the environment. Go to Window, XR, AR Foundation, click on XR Environment. In here, you will see how the environment will look like. At first, you will only see the default environment. You can also create your own environment or duplicate the existing environment and edit it as how you want it. Or you can install the sample environment from Unity. To do that, click on the environment dropdown and then click on Install Sample Environments. You can see a lot of different assets. Select which assets you want to add to your project and then click Import. To change the environment, click on the environment dropdown. For example, let's change it to dining room. When you click play, now the environment will change to dining room. You can also change the setting of its simulation environment by opening the environment prefab, then change the simulation environment component. To test plane tracking, if you add AR Plane Manager to XR Origin and add the plane prefab, then when you click play, if you look around, you'll be able to see the visualized plan. If you add AR Raycast Manager to XR Origin and press on plan script from Unity GitHub samples or from my tap to press video, when you tap on the trackables, you'll be able to spawn the plan prefab. For image tracking, in the simulation environment prefab, create a new game object. Then add simulated track image component to the new game object. Then add the texture 2D of the image that you want to track to the image variable. Set the image physical size matters to the expected size of the image in the real world. This will influence the distance at which an image can be detected by the simulated device. The next part is optional, but because you won't be able to see the image in XR simulation, If you want to be able to see the image just for better visualization, you can add a quad as the child of the simulated track image game object. Set the X rotation to 90. And set the scale to match the image physical size matters. Create a new material. And set the shader to under texture. Then add the image that you want to track to the material texture. Then add this material to the quad. Then move and rotate the simulated image game object according to how you want to place it. Then if you add AR Track Image Manager to XR Origin and add the track image prefab, when you click play, you will be able to see the track image prefab on the image game object. And that's all for this video. Please subscribe to my channel and check out my Patreon. If you have any question or suggestion, feel free to ask in the comment below. Thank you for watching.